In this video, I'm gonna share three things to consider whether you should build or buy a user onboarding solution like AppUse. Hey friends, it's Ramli John from AppUse. If you wanna get the latest user onboarding tips and tricks, be sure to smash that subscribe button. I've often heard this asked to me, should I just build a user onboarding solution myself? If you got a team of talented developers and designers, surely they can build custom product tours, checklists, and other in-app guides that can meet 100% of your users' needs. That's true. But before you do, here are three things to consider. Number one, the true costs. Now, when comparing the difference in cost between building or buying a user onboarding solution, most people think that building is cheaper because it's a one-time cost rather than an ongoing fee for a SaaS product like AppUse. But as your product naturally grows and you add more features, your user onboarding experience must adapt and change. User onboarding is not a set it and forget it activity. You need to update the user onboarding experience over time, time and time again. If you're considering building a user onboarding solution, you need to consider ongoing support and maintenance costs. Remember that anything you create has a maintenance cost. But in general though, for most businesses, the long-term costs of building in-house consistently outweigh those of buying an existing product. Number two, the speed of updates. Another thing to consider is the time it takes to implement updates to your user onboarding experience. As your design, customer success, sales, and marketing team learn more about your users, they'll likely want to update the copy and the design of your user onboarding. Now, when building a user onboarding solution, you should consider how long it will take for your team to implement those changes. If they have a strict product roadmap, it might take weeks or even months to make those updates. From my experience, product and engineering teams consider user onboarding updates less serious than core product releases and mission critical projects. And rightfully so. It's often why most user onboarding is a one-star experience rather than a five-star experience. Number three, the customization options. One of the limitations of buying a user onboarding solution is that you can only customize it to a certain point. Sure, you can change the colors, switch the fonts, make updates if you know some CSS, but if you want a truly bespoke user onboarding solution, buying it is not the way to go. If you feel that custom onboarding could offer your product a serious competitive advantage, then by all means, go after it. But let me give an example with shoes. Most folk would just buy their shoes from a shoe store. But there are certain situations when a bespoke custom-made shoe makes a huge difference. It could be orthopedic shoes for people with ankle sprains or postural disorders such as scoliosis. It could even be custom-made sneakers by well-known street artists that gain value over time. Make sure you know why you're building a bespoke custom-made onboarding. Maybe it fixes and meets a certain user need that an off-the-shelf tool or solution can't meet. Now to wrap it up, there are three things to consider whether you should buy or build a user onboarding solution. And they are, number one, true costs, second, the speed of updates, and third, customization options. The truth is, either option is not without risk. And at the end of the day, it really is about keeping your core product and customer experience in mind. To give you more context and idea, here's Tom. He's a product marketing manager at GetResponse, which serves over 350,000 customers like IKEA, Zendesk, and Stripe in 183 countries. Here's why he chose to buy a user onboarding solution like AppUse.
As a product marketing manager here at GetResponse, it was my job to increase the activation of our core products. We started with email marketing and we knew that we wanted to do this quickly, so we knew that IT wasn't a solution. We started looking at third-party tools, which is how we came across AppUse, and immediately we saw that this was the solution for us. I knew that I wasn't going to be able to experiment, that I was going to be able to have complete control over the flow, and you would be able to share it with teams like our UX team to get really quick sign-offs on it. We were super impressed with the results from the offset. We managed to increase the amount of emails that were being created by 60%.
Well, that's all for now. Let me know in the comments below if your company decided to buy or build an onboarding tool. Also, if you found this video valuable, feel free to share the love. Share it with your colleagues and friends. We've also created a free user onboarding certification course that details how to create an onboarding experience that turns more of your users into happy paying customers. We've got the link below in the description. Don't forget to subscribe as well to get the latest tips and tricks to improve your product's user onboarding. Well, that's all for now. This is Ramli John from AppUse. See you in the next video.